Okay, they make you look tired, older, and less attractive. So, how to get rid of under eye bags and dark circles?
If you have dark circles under your eyes, I may have a few tips for you. As with almost anything, of course, there's a means to genetics.
Sleep, of course, you need to fix your circadian rhythm.
Which Korean eye cream is right for you?
It's always sleep more, follow this trend, or buy this product. And nothing works. There's a whole industry trying to profit from your insecurity. And yes, I was insecure. And for years, I tried absolutely everything. So based on the research me and my team did the past year, we will show you what you can do from home that actually works. From quick fixes that will work overnight to long-term solutions nobody talks about, and also what methods to avoid. We will show you how to get rid of puffy eyes, hollow under eye bags, and dark circles. And we will help you to identify the causes. To provide honest science-backed advice, we decided to not promote a single product in this video. So no brand deals, no sponsorships, and no affiliate links. Let's begin. Sadly, there are no wonder products, and they will tell you anything to sell you something. There are only two essential products that will actually make a noticeable difference. First off, sunscreen. The skin around your eyes is super thin and highly vulnerable to UV damage, which can actually make dark circles worse and speed up aging. Studies showed that UV exposure breaks down the protein that keeps your skin elastic, called collagen. So you should use a good broad spectrum sunscreen with at least SPF 30, but we would advise choosing an SPF 50 that's specifically designed for the eye area to ensure maximum protection. Regular sunscreen formulas are often too heavy, which can lead to puffy eye bags, and the same applies to moisturizers. Daily protection, even if it's cloudy, will make a huge difference in preventing eye bags and dark circles. The second product we recommend is a peptide-based eye cream, especially in combination with the method we will discuss later. One of the main reasons for under eye bags is the lack of collagen, and peptides are like tiny signals to tell your skin to produce more collagen. In a study by Lee and colleagues, 75% of participants who used a peptide serum reported a noticeable decrease in the depth of under eye bags and wrinkles after the first month. Peptides function at the cellular level, that's why it's a gradual process that will take a few months, but the results will come and last. What's often recommended online for dark circles are retinoids like retinol or tretinoin. And yes, they can be effective, but please never apply them to the under eye area. These are your Meibomian glands. Their role is to moisturize your eyes and support tear production. When you apply retinoids in this area, you risk drying out these glands, leading to chronic dryness and irritation. Many patients have reported this issue, and unfortunately, it can be irreversible. So you will struggle with dry eyes for your whole life. Sadly, you won't find any clear guides online on the use of retinoids, which is why we have asked Robert Mann, a dermatologist, to outline the correct application areas for you. If you have puffy eyes, it's probably due to water retention. Too much sodium causes bloating, which leads to puffiness and dark shadows. The fix? Increase your potassium intake with foods like salmon, bananas, or coconut water, and reduce your salt intake. And please note that fluid balance is about the right ratio of sodium to potassium, so overdoing it like that will lead to even more fluid retention. It's also an option to take a properly dosed potassium supplement. We suggest to take it in the morning to flush out excess water and keep puffy eyes away for the day. Another reason for puffy eyes could be the use of moisturizers that are not formulated especially for the skin of the under eye area. Regular face moisturizers can be too heavy for the skin, leading to excess fluid retention. This can cause puffiness as the product either doesn't absorb properly or clogs the skin's natural drainage system. That's why it's important to choose a lightweight, eye-specific moisturizer like these. Something a lot of people talked about that you definitely should not do to reduce under eye bags are facial exercises. During our research, we found hundreds of videos promoting them. At first, it makes sense. Like any muscle, the more you work it, the better it should look. But the truth is, facial exercises actually accelerate visual aging. Instead of improving the skin tone, like some people think, they actually put more stress on the skin. The skin under your eyes is not only the thinnest on your body, but it also has way less oil glands compared to other areas. When you repeatedly stretch or pull on this type of skin, it causes micro tears in the collagen fibers. Over time, these fibers lose their ability to bounce back, making the skin looser and more prone to sagging. Dynamic wrinkles will become static wrinkles. That means what starts as fine lines during movement eventually becomes permanent, even when your face is at rest. It's like a rubber band. The more you stretch it, the weaker and looser it becomes, and this can make under eye bags appear even worse. Facial exercises might sound like a quick fix, but when it comes to the under eye area, you're probably doing more harm than good. We do not accept brand deals and do not use affiliate links, so if you want to support this type of content, then leave a like and maybe consider subscribing. If you have under eye bags that appear sunken or hollow, it's usually due to a combination of volume loss and the lack of collagen. In this case, microneedling might help out. You've likely heard of microneedling before. You or a professional uses a tool with tiny needles to create micro injuries in the skin. These injuries are superficial, but they are just enough to trigger your body's natural healing response. When the skin is punctured, the body perceives it as a kind of injury, so it ramps up collagen and elastin production to repair the skin. As the body produces new collagen, it helps restore volume to the under eye area, filling out that hollow, sunken appearance. If you want to perform it at home, we suggest to start with a 0.2mm needle. Most people order a basic demo roller on the internet, but those are usually coming with a 0.5mm needle and will penetrate the skin too deeply because the under eye area skin is so thin. Microneedling is only effective when performed regularly. However, it's crucial to wait until the skin has fully healed before performing another session. Practicing it one or two times a week is enough for most people. If you want us to make a detailed video about at-home microneedling, then comment it. Another method that can help to achieve permanent results is red light therapy. It can also be performed at home and is especially effective in combination with microneedling. You basically use low wavelength red light to penetrate the skin and stimulate cellular repair. As a result, this stimulates collagen and elastin production, helping restore volume. We suggest to use a high quality red light panel that's especially designed for skincare. 10 minutes per session, 2-3 times a week is enough. Do not expect fast results from this, but over time, in combination with the other methods, it will make a noticeable difference. And please note to not use red light therapy directly after microneedling to avoid overstimulating freshly treated skin. So you now know that the lack of collagen is one of the main reasons for under eye bags. So how can we boost our skin's collagen production even more? You can simply try to take a collagen peptide supplement. When consumed, collagen peptides break down into amino acids, the building blocks of collagen. These amino acids specifically stimulate collagen production in the skin. It's especially effective when combined with microneedling, red light therapy, and the topical use of peptide serums. Your body can only absorb a limited amount of collagen peptides. We suggest to take 0.15 grams of collagen per kilogram body weight. Studies show that the most effective source of collagen peptides comes from animal sources. But please note that collagen production also relies on cofactors like vitamin C and zinc. Without these, even the best collagen supplement won't be as effective. Micronutrients not only play a role in better collagen production, but can also directly affect your under eyes. Your skin is an organ, and nutrient deficiencies often show up first under your eyes because this area has the thinnest skin on your body. For example, low iron reduces oxygen to tissues, causing blood to pool and darken the under eye area, which is quite a common cause for dark circles not so many people know. So if you can't figure out why you have chronic under eye bags and dark circles, then maybe consider doing a blood test. It could give you clarity. During our research, we watched countless videos, read articles, and spoke to dermatologists to prepare. But no one talks about that the development of your jaw, especially the maxilla, is a major cause of under eye bags. The maxilla is a key bone supporting the area around your eyes, and its shape and position can affect under eye bags drastically. Take a look at this transformation. Because the maxilla got more prominent over time, it pushed the skin forward and upward, adding volume and reducing hollowness. So if you have an underdeveloped jaw and always thought your hollow under eye bags are due to genetics, then that's probably the real cause. But there are countless things you can do to improve jaw development. Mouth breathing is one of the main causes for recessed jaws, so it's really important to solely breathe through the nose at all times. We suggest to try nasal strips to help with that, and additionally try to tape off the mouth during the night. If you think recessed bones are the cause of your under eye bags, there are also countless other things you can look into that might help you, like orthotropics, orthodontics, and for example, exercises for proper posture. Sadly, the industry also tries to exploit that insecurity, so please avoid overpriced nasal strips, guides, and products promoted by influencers, and always do your own research. A product that's often used for treating hyperpigmentation and dark circles is hydroquinone. While it's effective in what it's made for, reducing melanin-caused dark spots, it has one common side effect, the thinning of skin. As you know, the skin under your eyes is already extremely thin, so this can result in blood vessels underneath becoming way more visible and worsening the appearance of dark circles. It's also worth noting that hydroquinone was banned throughout Europe due to increasing the risk of cancer, so just don't use it. Another seemingly quick fix you should absolutely avoid is injecting under eye circles with hyaluronic acid. Yes, nearly every surgeon will recommend it to you. It's a quick and easy solution that works. but you will pay the price later, and we are not talking about the bill.
After several years of doing tear trough filler, I started to question this, as we had several cases where swelling or puffiness persisted for many years, well beyond the 6 to 18 months we were told that fillers last. Sometimes the puffiness occurred years after having what appeared to be a good result.
On platforms like Reddit or medical forums, you will find hundreds of stories from patients that regret this procedure. The filler can migrate away from the under eye area, causing asymmetry, lumps, and worsening the under eye bags even more. That's why most of the patients need constant touch-ups. For surgeons and other people practicing these fillers, it's a quick and easy way to earn a lot of money and have satisfied customers, at least for the first few months. So do yourself the favor and do not choose the quick and seemingly easy way. I'm sure you will find a way that works for you. So here are your key takeaways on what actually works. If you need a quick temporary fix for dark circles due to puffiness, then cool your under eyes, increase your potassium intake, and sleep on your back. The only two creams you actually need are a good sunscreen made for the eye area and a peptide-based cream. You should avoid retinoids, hydroquinone, and regular face moisturizers. Do not practice facial exercises because they will create wrinkles and worsen the eye bags over time. Remember, the skin was not made for this kind of repeated stress. If you have hollow under eye bags, try microneedling to restore volume, use red light therapy and collagen peptide supplements to help stimulate collagen production. Look into jaw development methods like nasal breathing, orthotropics and orthodontics if your jaw is recessed and causes hollow under eye bags. Get your blood checked to identify deficiencies that can cause under eye bags and especially dark circles like iron, zinc and vitamin C. And finally, avoid hyaluronic acid injections, as they will make everything even worse. Don't let the industry exploit your insecurity. Don't believe any advertising claims. We do not want to be part of the problem, so help us stay independent. If you appreciate this kind of content and the year of research behind it, leave a like and subscribe. I hope we were able to help you. Bye!